Later, Jack Arnold, now an old man in his 90s, in a wheelchair, frail. He is then interrupted, or at least have a knock on the door. It's Griffin and Dorian. Jack Griffin, the current invisible man. Agent Jack Arnold. Jack then saying, "Oh, what do you want?" "You know what we want." Gray then says, "The event is occurring again. As you know, once a century or sometimes twice in a rare occasion, the planets align and it causes an event. We need to stop that event, or at least find a way to handle it, because with this being the 21st century, we don't know if we can convince the world that it's an illusion now." "I hear you've been putting a team together, training what, that big monster you found in the ice? His name is Adam Frankenstein, and yes, we have been training him for the past 2 years, along with Ava Van Helsing and other recruits we have. We're putting a team together and we think he is a good candidate." "You're sick," said Gray. "You're dying. The Gillman is going to need a purpose other than you. Please, let us speak with him."
"Very well.
Come along," as he wheels with his electric wheelchair. He then takes him to the Gillman's enclosure, and in his tank he meditates. Jack tells him that over the years he's educated him and become like a surrogate father, also stating that he ages slower. When he first came across him, he was only a child, but during the time he took him in 1974, he was still young and adolescent. Now he's only early middle age, as his species seem to live longer and have a slow metabolism. Jack then says, "He is well into his 90s like me, but still young for his kind." Then the Gillman goes up to the glass. And then Griffin walks up saying, "Hello, Gillian. I believe that you are aware of Agent Arnold's situation. How would you like to pull your way around and prove to the world that not all monsters like you are evil?" Then Dorian says, "I've got a beeper going off. I'm wanted down at the labs. That rift is peaking again." "Okay, Mr. Gray. Thank you." The Gillman then comes out of the water tank and approaches Griffin. He then says, "What do you want from me?" "I'm putting a team together and I think you would be quite good in a particular role. How about it? Then Jack starts to cough and starts to fall out of his chair. Then Griffin shouts, "Somebody get a medic in here!" In the Foundation Infirmary, Jack lays in his bed. Gillian then saying, "He is withering. Humans don't live as long as my kind did." "You speak good English." "Jack taught me, helped me over the years. I am forever indebted to him, but I cannot save him from old age." "I'm afraid not. He could become a vampire or a ghost. But I'm afraid he is very ill." Then one of the doctors say, "He hasn't got long. I think you better say your goodbyes now. Thank you. Would you like to?" "Yes." Gillian then approaches Jack Arnold saying,
"Jack. Gillian. Hello, my friend. You are dying. Your time is short. I know. Listen. I think you'll be all right here. But without me, you're going to need to pull your weight around here now. Help out here at the Foundation. I think you could help lead man into a new age where they will know of monsters' existence. I know that. I think that's what Dr. Griffin out there is getting everything ready for. Because he's right. With the technological advancements man have made in the last century, with cameras and phones, it's only a matter of time before we can say that it's not a hoax. So be good to yourself and take care."
Then Jack dies there and then. Gillman then sheds a tear and places his hand on Jack's hand. He then leaves the room. Then Griffin approaches him saying, "I'm sorry, Gillian. Truly I am."
"He was my only friend here."
"I can be your friend. So can all these other people that I've put together."
"Other people?"
"Yes. I'm putting a squad together because I fear that this event, the event where the barriers between worlds are weakest because of the planet's alignments that set off a chain reaction, whatever comes through these rifts, because of we don't know what could. We need a team to fight them if they do try and cause a world predicament."
"I'm listening," said Gillman.
Meanwhile, deep in one of the Foundation labs, Dorian stands there saying, "Are you sure these stones are as they were when they last triggered the portal?"
"Yes, I believe so, Mr. Gray. But I can honestly tell you, I don't know why you've done this.
Because he is coming through. I mean, I don't know if he's going to be alive or dead, but it's worth a check. What makes you think that he could be in there? Because time moves differently in other dimensions. I remember once I was in some realm for 12 weeks and it had only been 2 minutes in this world. As I said, time moves differently in other worlds. Hopefully, times move differently in this one where he ended up. Who did? Mr. Hyde, but he could have reverted back to Dr. Jekyll, I don't know. Then, the rift opens. A portal opens. Then, stepping out of it is a man in tattered up, worn out clothes. Walking out, he then says, "Ha! Finally! I've been in there for days! I was beginning to lose hope! Damn that Edward for putting me there! Mr. Grey! Henry. Henry Jekyll. Yes, that's right. What happened? How long did you say it's been for you? I don't know. A couple of days, about 5 at the most. What, like 120 hours? Yes, why? What's going on? I mean, last thing I remember, some tentacle being was coming out of a portal and I had to let Hyde out, even though I didn't want to, but... Well, Griffin told me I could use Hyde as a weapon until I could find a way to control it. Speaking of that, where is Griffin? Our colleague, Hawley Griffin, has been dead for some time, about 100 years. What are you talking about? We do have a Griffin here, an invisible man, but it's his great-grandson who runs things, who I made the director of the Foundation in the early 2000s.
2000s?
Henry, I'm sorry to tell you this, but... time has clearly moved differently in that dimension wherever you've been. It's been 120 years for this world since you disappeared into that world. I'm sorry, Jekyll. Are you going to be all right?
I don't know, it's just... I don't know.
Then, Jekyll hears a cackle of a man in his head. Closing his eyes. Residential suite. Dr. Jekyll sits as he watches the television, being amazed by it, saying, "It's amazing. Back in the day, stuff like this had only just been made, where it was a train where people thought it was going to come out at you. Now, it's all in this small box thing. I know someone is there," said Jekyll. Then, the television then turns off. Griffin then appears, after being invisible, saying to Dr. Jekyll, "It's called a television, one of the biggest inventions of the 20th century. Now everybody has one. Why am I here? Are you on a mission or something?
I am, said Griffin. What, trying to adjust me into this world?
No, I'm trying to save it.
And we can still do with your secret weapon.
It was a bad idea that your great-grandfather suggested to me. I wish I'd not listened to him, because now I'm out here in a time where I should be dead.
Of course, I am putting a team together. What if I could talk to your other side? My other side. Then Jekyll looks at his reflection in the screen of the TV, where he sees a figure of a taller, inhuman-like being saying,
I think it's worth a listen. Don't you, Henry?
Jekyll then looks at Griffin and says, I think it's worth a listen.